Welcome to CLT's video for how to manage two cross-listed courses that use different weighted grades in the Canvas gradebook. First, it's important to note that this is intended to be used when you have two different sections cross-listed in the same Canvas shell, such as a 495 and 595 undergraduate and graduate mixed section. Before setting up the gradebook, this process works best for weighted grades as a total grade uses a different process. Both courses must be weighted out of 100%. This process is not compatible with late policies or grade posting policies in the gradebook settings. From People in the course navigation menu, select Plus Group Set in the top right corner. Under Group Set Name, name the group in a way that helps you and your students identify what the group is for. For example, a course that is running during the fall 2022 semester may be named something like Fall 2022 495-595. Under Self Sign Up, leave that blank, and under Group Structure, select Create Groups Later and press Save. Now that you've created the group set, you need to make groups within the group set. First, click Plus Group on the top right corner. In the pop-up, the group name should be one of the cross-listed sections, such as 495 Fall 2022 or 595 Fall 2022. Leave group membership limit blank and press Save. Replicate that process for as many groups as you need. Again, the number of groups in this group set will be dictated by how many cross-listed sections you have. Now that you have your groups, you need to add your students to the groups. You will add each student to the correct group. You may do this by either dragging and dropping each student via the 8-pack to the left of their name, or clicking the small plus to the right of their name and selecting the correct group. In order to generate properly weighted grades, you need to make assignment groups for each section. For ease of understanding for both you and your students, it's a good practice to name each assignment group with that section's course number at the start, such as 495, Paper 1. In order to make the assignment groups, navigate to the assignments from the course navigation menu. On the top right, select Plus Group, and name each assignment group as is listed on your syllabus to generate a weighted score. Now that you have all of your assignment groups created, you need to weight them identically to your course syllabus. On the top right, click the three-dot kebab and select Assignment Group Weight. In this pop-up, carefully enter the appropriate weight for each category and be careful to ensure that the information matches your course syllabus. Now that you've created your assignment groups and weighted them, you need to make assignments. When making assignments, it is critically important to not publish the assignment until you have added the groups to the assignment. You may decide to make placeholder assignments that you will update at a later date for this step. This step may be used for assignments, graded discussions, or quizzes. When you create an assignment, ensure that you put the course number at the start of the assignment title for clarity. In order to make the assignments, complete the following. Navigate to the assignments index page from the assignments link in the course navigation menu. Select plus assignment on the top right. For the assignment name, name the assignment what you will communicate to your students with the name of their section first, such as 495, Paper 1. Set the anticipated number of points for the assignment. Under Submission Type, select No Submission, and then press Save at the bottom right, not Save and Publish. Remember, this is a placeholder that you will update later. Now you want to return to the assignments index page. Now that we've made a placeholder assignment, we need to duplicate it as many times as there are assignments. For this example course, there are 9 assignments, so I need to make 8 duplicates of the placeholder assignment. To the far right of the assignment's name, select the 3-dot kebab, and then select Duplicate. And replicate that process as many times as needed. Now that we have all of our placeholder assignments, we can move them into each assignment group. This can be done either by drag and drop to the far left of the assignment's name from the 8-pack, or you can select the 3-dot kebab to the far right of the assignment's name and select Move To, and you can select which assignment group you'd like to move it to. With the placeholders generated and placed in the correct assignment group, it's time to update them. From the Assignment Index page from the course navigation menu, click the assignment's name that you would like to update. Click Edit on the top right of the page, and update the assignment's name as needed. Remember to leave the course number in front of the assignment's name. Update these instructions as needed. If needed, adjust the point value or the submission type. And now by group, you're going to want to select the radio button, "This is a group assignment." This opens an additional checkbox that you must also click, assign grades to each student individually. Under group set, select the group where you divided your students into groups correlating to the number of cross-listed sections. Under assign, delete everyone from assign, and then select the appropriate group. Because this is an assignment for the 495 section, I'm going to select the 495 group. Update due dates as needed, and press Save and Publish. You're going to get a warning that not all students have been assigned to the group. Go ahead and click Continue. Complete this step for each assignment in the course. Now that you've updated all of your assignments, it's time to put them in the modules. When adding the assignments to the modules, it's important to make sure you add all of the assignments to the module. Remember that you have multiple sections cross-listed in the same Canvas shell. Navigate to the Modules Index page from the Modules link in the course navigation menu. Locate the module where you want to deploy the assignment. Select the plus on the far right of the module and select Add Assignment. Because the example section has two cross-listed sections, I will be adding two assignments. I'm going to add the 495 paper one, and I'm going to add the 595 paper one. Now my students are able to access and complete the materials as I intended, and my gradebook will maintain the weights for the different sections. Now that you've deployed all of your assignments to the specific groups, it's important to note how the gradebook appears. In the gradebook, the cells for students who cannot complete an assignment are grayed out. For example, Eric and Emily are in the 595 section, so I cannot enter a grade for them for the 495 section's assignments. Thank you for watching. For more information, visit clt.odu.edu.